And our top story this hour comes in from India, where the race to the 2019 Lok Sabha elections in India is heating up. And how? One-time arch rivals, the Samajwadi Party and the Bahujan Samaj Party, have announced an alliance to take on the ruling Bharatiya Janata Party in the crucial heartland state of Uttar Pradesh. The state sends 80 of the 545 members to the lower house of parliament and had been swept by the BJP in the last general elections. It was exactly 25 years ago that Mulayam Singh Yadav and Kanshi Ram joined hands to stop the BJP's might at the height of the Ayodhya movement. Fast forward to 2019, and the SP patriarch's scion has cemented ties with the Dalit icon's protege. Mayawati has confirmed that Congress will not be a part of the alliance, since SP-BSP will get no political profit out of this tie-up. Both parties will contest 38 seats each, while leaving out 2 seats to other parties. Besides the traditional seats of Congress leaders Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi, Amethi and Rae Bareli to the Congress, announcing that she has moved on from the 1995 guest house incident for the benefit of the country. BSP Supremo Mayawati said, "Let bygones be bygones." The duo are eyeing to challenge the BJP, which won 71 of the 80 seats in the last Lok Sabha elections.
Uttar Pradesh mein kul 80 Lok Sabha ki seate hain, jisme se BSP 38 लोकसभा की सीटों पर और एसपी 38 लोकसभा की सीटों पर मिलकर ये चुनाव लड़ेगी और 2 लोकसभा की सीटें हमने अभी 1-2 और पार्टियों के लिए छोड़ दी है। इनके अलावा 2 और शेष बची सीटें अर्थात अमेठी व रायबरेली, ये दोनों लोकसभा की सीटें हमने कांग्रेस पार्टी के साथ बिना कोई गठबंधन किए हुए ही इस पार्टी के लिए छोड़ दिए हैं।
And to bring us more details and add perspective to this news story, I'm joined in by our correspondent Mohammed Salih, who joins me live from the newsroom. Mohammed, this is very interesting. You know, this is an alliance that we are looking at again after 25 years between the SP and BSP. Will these two be able to work the magic again that Mulayam Singh and Kanshi Ram had done almost at the peak of the Ayodhya movement back then?
You know, will they be able to work the magic? That is something that we'll find out in the next few months, Akansha. But what is very important about it, about this alliance, is that this in many ways is the most crucial and the most defining pre-poll alliance ahead of the 2019 general elections. Because remember, the state of Uttar Pradesh is the one with 80 seats in the parliament. It is the largest state. And the reason as to why this alliance, you know, is so significant is at the time of 2014, at the time of Modi wave being at its peak, the BJP had swept this state, winning 71 out of the 80. 2 seats had been won by one of its allies, and therefore the BJP and allies had walked away with 73 seats. But now with Akhilesh Yadav and Mayawati coming together, you know, that is of course going to be dented in a very significant way. Remember, the BSP and SP in the bi-polls that were held in Phulpur and in Gorakhpur had exhibited the fact that yes, when they come together, they can in fact take on the might of Narendra Modi and they can beat BJP in their own bastions. So how will all of this play out? This of course is up for the bet. But what is very clear is that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is not only dealing with anti-incumbency, but he's also dealing with some very cold caste arithmetic that he will have to come up with. Now, what is also important to state here and emphasize upon is that the Congress has been left out of this alliance. And this again has been done in a very smart manner. They have left 2 seats out.
Just about to come to that, this is another very important aspect of this alliance that we are looking at. As you rightly mentioned, that Congress has been left out of this alliance. How do you see this entire change? Actually, is this going to impact the entire alliance and the shaping up of the election results?
Okay, now that is still something that we'll get to know. But what is important and what needs to be stated here, Kansha, is that, some months back, at the time when the opposition looked in complete disarray, this, of course, has changed after the elections in 5 states where the BJP was not able to win even a single state. The Congress is now on the ascendant. They've been able to win 3 big Hindi heartland states. They're now in power in Rajasthan, in Madhya Pradesh and in Chhattisgarh. The BJP in the Hindi heartland is not in exactly the position that it was in 2014. So the Congress remembers some months back Sonia Gandhi had said that the way to take on the might of Narendra Modi is to field one candidate against a candidate that is fielded by the BJP. And that is pretty much what is likely to play out. Because remember, this is not going to be a direct presidential kind of a contest between two leaders here. What is going to happen is that these are these small alliances which will actually shape and define what will happen in 2019 in India.
Very rightly said, these are the small alliances which will shape the elections of 2019 in India. Also, interestingly enough, as Mayawati pointed out, that they have to look at their political profits, which is why Congress had been left aside. Thank you so much, Mohammed Salih, for bringing us all the latest on this news story.